I want to thank John and Jonathan for their words of welcome. Since we have a large topic and a very distinguished panel, I think I'll add just a few introductory remarks based on my own personal experience and also my university's experience that might help to frame our conversation tonight. When I first became engaged in thinking hard about technology-enhanced education, I would often be asked by faculty colleagues, and I see a number of them in this room here tonight, the same question: why all the sudden interest? And of course, at one level, as Jonathan has said, there's nothing sudden about the use of technology as an adjunct to learning. This university can even claim to have been at one time a pioneer in this space, since from 1957 to 82, it partnered with CBS to produce an Emmy Award series, Sunrise Semester, televised lecture courses, which some people will remember here, viewed for free or for a modest fee taken for credit. These courses were, in a very real sense, a pre-digital forerunner of today's MOOCs. More recently, as Jonathan noted, we have offered a variety of online and blended hybrid programs, mostly, not exclusively, but mostly at the graduate, professional, and executive education level. And as he said, at last count, almost 700 such courses in those programs. Still, despite this historical and present level of engagement, my faculty colleagues who asked that question were right, since there is indeed something new, even urgent, about our present preoccupation. For one thing, the conversation about technology has been implicated, for better or for worse, in a larger discourse on higher education that focuses on the cost of college, on student indebtedness, on faltering job prospects in an economy where many industries are being negatively disrupted by technology. It raises questions: will higher education be next, or will technology save us by increasing access, enhancing efficiencies, reducing cost? Even more importantly, I think, and putting these operational considerations aside for a moment, there's now a sense that technology has a potential impact on all aspects of what we do, not just research, which of course we all know, but also teaching, advising, and mentoring. And not just in the graduate and professional space, but also in undergraduate education and in the liberal arts. And finally, there's an increasing realization that technology is not just an adjunct to learning along this entire continuum, but that it can actually transform in significant ways how learning takes place, blurring the distinction between didactic teaching on the one hand and research on the other, and potentially altering forever the roles of faculty and students in ways that might to some be unsettling, but conversely to others, deeply, deeply empowering. I want to take this opportunity to recognize the important leadership role that our president, John, and our provost, Dave McLaughlin, have had in catalyzing constructive conversations on this campus and productive action in this space. By charging a faculty committee to explore the future of technology-enhanced education, they signaled that it was important for strategic thinking in this area to be guided by our faculty. The committee focused on how technology might help achieve a variety of goals that other universities are also looking at, of course, from improving teaching and learning to enhancing access and to mitigating risk. But the committee also focused on one other goal that was specific to our institution and which John also alluded to a moment ago, namely how technology might promote the circulation of students, of faculty, and of ideas throughout our far-flung but deeply interconnected global network. Not surprisingly, the committee's report that came out about a year ago embraced experimentation along the entire continuum. As befits an organization as complex as ours, it also advised that no one size fits all, that our experiments need to be rigorously assessed, and that the results of this research should be disseminated widely. Since the report was issued, our interest in this area, I think it's fair to say, has grown exponentially in all of our schools, and significant investment has followed. From our local experience, I think that one thing is certain, and folks from other universities in this room may have that same experience, technology is here to stay. But equally certain is that it's evolving, and we can't necessarily say exactly where it will lead, both within the residential university and in other non-traditional academic settings. And it's this evolution that is our topic here today. So our plan is as follows. Each panelist will speak for 15 minutes. Our first panelist will be Nicholas Lemann, the Henry R. Luce Professor of Journalism and the former Dean of the Columbia University Graduate School of Journalism. Our next speaker will be Kevin Guthrie, the President of Ithaka. And finally, we'll hear from Daphne Koller, the President and co-founder of Coursera and the Rajeev Motwani Professor of Computer Science at Stanford University. I'd like us to ask you all to hold your questions until all three have presented, and then at that point, I propose to open the floor for discussion.